Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video we are going to discuss few tips for engineering mini projects and final projects. Okay, let's start. The first important tip is personal interest. Personal interest means choose the project on which you have interest. Okay, personal interest. Second one is practical. Practical means the project which you choose should be practical. It should not be of imagination. Okay, it should be practically possible. Okay, next tip is learn the basics. Okay, if you decided to develop a project using C language or using Java or using some other language, you should be strong enough in the basics so that you can easily develop the project. Okay, always be strong in the basics and have a very good knowledge in the basics of the technologies of which you are going to develop the project. Okay, next is less code and cost effective. See, when you are in final year, you are just preparing a project for marks. Okay, but once the next stage is getting a job, okay, being recruited. Okay, once you go into the job, the company will look for the application or the project which is having the less code and the cost effective. Okay, less code, why? Because the storage space will be saved. Cost effective, because cost effective, it will save the cost, and just for one project the company cannot spend lots of money. Okay, so the project which you develop should use the less code and cost effective. Okay, so that then your project will be very unique and it will be most demanded. Okay, next tip is project should be interesting and unique. See, basically engineering students, if one person starts a project, remaining all his friends will start following him. Okay, whatever he do, with just few differences, they also will start doing the similar kind of project. This is the wrong path. Okay, you should not follow this path, because the project should be interesting. Because if all your classmates does the same project, it will not be interesting and it will not be unique, because all are having same project, all are having same code. So remember, your project always should be unique and interesting. Okay, next, think of the future means next you are going to step into a company, and there the project which you do should help in your job also. Like do similar kind of projects which helps even in future. Okay, do the projects on Java, PHP, like that, which are emerging technologies. Okay, don't use old technologies, outdated technologies and all. Think about the future and then select the project. Next is don't go too difficult. Some students will be so enthusiastic and they'll just start selecting the too difficult project. Okay, till blueprint it is okay, because you just need to give the blueprint of the project. If it is difficult also, you can easily give off the project blueprint. But once the blueprint is finalized, remember, you have to make that blueprint practical. You have to start developing the project. Okay, if you select the most difficult project, no one are going to help you. You should work so hard. So never go to too difficult project. Okay, and try not to buy the project. Try it yourself. Okay, most of the engineering students will just simply go to Amirpet or some other institutions and easily they just spend money and buy the project. Okay, for instance, for marks it is okay, but later when you go for job, you will have no experience with the project, because you didn't do it, you just bought it. So this is the wrong path. Okay, always try it by yourself. Okay, the advantage is that, see, when you create a resume, in that, in achievements or experience of the project, you can mention the project which you have done, and in those kind of situations, the person who is interviewing you will also ask, how did you do that project? What are the technologies you used? And what is the kind of code you wrote? All these questions will be asked by the interviewer, okay? Then if you just buy the project, you don't know anything, so you can't answer any of these questions. And when you go to job, you will not have any of the practical knowledge because you didn't do that project, you just bought it. That's why always it's better to try by yourself, okay? Next is, your project should create a solution, okay? For example, let it be some application called sports scoring system, okay? Sports scoring system, okay? So this is an application. When you are developing this application, don't just try to develop the same application which your seniors developed. Don't try to do the same thing. See, sports coding applications, there are few disadvantages, like there are few limitations. That is, scoring system cannot display the local matches scores and few other things, like limitations will be there. Try to find out the solutions. That is, your application should find the solution for the find the solution and give the local scores also, local sports scores also. It should provide that is it should provide the solution for the previous problems, okay? Choose that kind of projects, okay? Next is, choose apt technology, okay? If you want to do a project, first try to know which technology is apt for it. Python or PHP or Java or C or C++, then decide the technology and then start the project, okay? Next, don't do just for the sake of marks. Few people will just do the project for the sake of marks. No, you have to learn practical knowledge. You have to have the practical knowledge because that will be useful in while your campus placements, and while once you step into the company, that knowledge will be useful, okay? So don't just do it for the sake of marks. Next is, mention the project in your resume. In achievements, okay, just mention the project which you did, and mention the technologies, title of the project which you used in the project, and technologies used, and 2 to 3 lines of the code and description. All this it's better to mention in the resume so that they will have a good impact and they'll come to know that you have good knowledge in developing a project, so you'll surely be recruited, okay? This is an added advantage. Next, stay updated with the technology, okay? Once you start developing a project, don't use outdated technologies. Use the updated technologies such as Java, PHP, Python, JDBC, all these technologies. Use the updated technologies, okay? And mainly Java. Java is the most important technology, and most of the companies will prefer the students who have very good knowledge in Java, okay? Because Java is open source. Open source means Java is free to use, and Java can develop the applications which can run in any operating system, and Java can develop the web applications. Web applications advantages are, these applications no need to install. So these are the 3 advantages of Java. So all the companies will apt Java students, okay? The students who are having very good knowledge in Java, they'll surely be recruited. So have very good knowledge in core Java and all. So these are the few tips which will be helpful for the engineering students while doing a project. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to share and subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get the future notifications of my video. Thank you so much for watching this video.